get qualifying underway as Deke Waters rolls onto the racetrack out of turn to number two. Deke Waters on the clock now as Troy Davenport goes down the back straightaway into turns three and four. He's going to be on the clock as he passes the flag stand. Both cars on the time clock now. Deke Waters going to come across with a first lap time. 13.369 for Deke Waters as Troy Davenport comes out of turn number four with a first lap time. It's going to be a 13.503. Second lap time for Troy Davenport's going to be a 13.318, but Deke Waters is going to be the quick one out of the two with a 13.257. 13.257 for Deke Waters. Next two cars rolling onto the racetrack. It's going to be Zach Shannon in the Z1, and the three is not going to make the call, so we're going to roll down to the 72 of Steve Russell. Both cars on the clock now. Zach Shannon, he is your Sportsman late model points leader here at Crossville Speedway as he's going to turn a lap time of 13.288. 13.288 for Zach Shannon. As Steve Russell is going to turn a lap time of 13.169. Steve Russell's going to move to the leaderboard, 13.169. Zach Shannon's going to move into the number two spot with a 13.224. And then Steve Russell's going to better it with a 13.059. And the 36 of Evan Taylor. Those are going to be your next two cars as Chase Walls goes into turn number three. Evan Taylor comes out of turn number two. We're going to be qualifying great late models, Chase Walls. Evan Taylor, both on the clock now. Chasing down a 13.059, put in by Steve Russell. First lap time for Chase Wall is going to be a 13.681, 13.681. First lap time for Evan Taylor is going to be a 13.727, 13.727. Next lap time for Chase Walls, 13.512, 13.512 for Chase Walls. Evan Taylor with a 13.736, 13.736 for Evan Taylor. Steve Russell still sits on top of the leaderboard with a 13.059 as Floyd Turner pulls onto the racetrack in the 50, followed by the two of Scott Cook. Scott Cook going to be your second crate late model on the racetrack. Floyd Turner comes down the front straightaway as he gets on the clock. Yellow flag's going to come out. Steve Cook did not get on the gas pedal soon enough. So we're going to line them back up. Floyd Turner was the first one out. Steve Cook did not get on the racetrack quick enough, so we're going to start it back. Here we go. Qualifying crate late models, Floyd Turner in the black and orange 50. Steve Cook in the black and white 2. Scott Cook in the black and white 2. So Floyd Turner's going to come out of turn number 4 with a first lap time of 13.647, 13.647. Scott Cook's going to be turning the time of 13.363, 13.363. That's going to put Scott Cook in the number 5 spot as Floyd Turner comes out of 4 with the final lap time. 13.550. Scott Cook's going to be a 13.260. 13.260. That puts Scott Cook in the number 4 spot. Floyd Turner is going to be in the number 7 spot as we pull onto the racetrack. Going to be the 27 of Jaden Frame, followed by the Crossville, Tennessee driver, the 15 of Michael Smith. Michael Smith going to roll out of turn number 2, get on the loud pedal, down the back straightaway. Jaden Frame in the 27 on the clock. Michael Smith as well. Jaden's going to come out of turn number 4. We're going to be looking at a first lap time. It will be a 13.793. Michael Smith out of turn four with a first lap time. 13.363. It's going to put him in the number six spot. Second lap time, 13.664 for Jaden Frame. Michael Smith with a 13.300. So Michael Smith moves up to the number five spot. Number two lap was the quick one for him. Now we're going to pull on the racetrack, the 77 of Perry Delaney, followed by the Crossville, Tennessee driver in the CVR chassis. That's going to be the 5J of Jesse Lowe. Perry Delaney's going to push up the racetrack in 3 and 4, get back on the loud pedal. He's got to make up some momentum as Jesse Lowe's going to work the top side down in 3 and 4 as he comes down the front straightaway on the clock now. Jesse Lowe with 17 wins on this season, trying to pick up number win 18. Perry Delaney's going to turn a lap time of 13.675. Jesse Lowe with a 13.005. That's going to put Jesse Lowe on the pole position. 055, that moves him to the pole position. 13.362 for Perry Delaney, and then Jesse Lowe's going to turn a 13.074. Jesse Lowe in the 5J moves to the leaderboard with a 13.055. Your last car and crate late model qualifying is going to be the 7 of Justin Smith. Justin Smith is looking to beat that time of 13.055 put in by the Crossville, Tennessee driver, Jesse Lowe. Listen to the throttle control as he's the only race car on the track. You get to hear him mark it down in 3 as he comes into 4, coming out of 4. First lap time for Justin Smith will be a 13.451. 13.451. Final lap time for Justin Smith is going to be a 13.148. So Jesse Lowe in the 5J is going to sit on top of the leaderboard with a 13.055, followed by Steve Russell with a 13.059. Justin Smith with a 13.148. That's going to be your top three cars. When we go to our crate late model feature tonight. Now we will double them up. Two by two, nose to tail, door handle to door handle. As Dusty McDaniel, your Crossville Speedway flag man, will be giving them the one to go sign this time around. After an awesome Ultimate Super Late Model show, we're going to go crate late model racing, street stocks. You need to be in staging. The one to go sign is out. Half off food at the concession stand. Half off food at the concession stand. Crossville, Tennessee, Cumberland County. Crossville Speedway, we come out of turn number 4. It's going to be your crate late model feature race of the night, 25 laps the distance. You are watching this on Speedway Video Productions. Jesse Lowe's going to be jumping out front, following by Steve Russell in second, then the 7 of Justin Smith going to fall in third. Zach Shannon in fourth, D-Quarters in fifth. We come out of turn number 4. First lap is going to be in the books as we go 3 wide down the front straightaway. Michael Smith, Davenport, and Cook battling it out for the number 6 spot on the racetrack as Jesse Lowe's going to take lap number 2. Starting to pull away from the pack. Steve Russell second. Zach Shannon has moved to the number 3 spot. Dee Quaters in 4. So Jesse Lowe in the 5J, the 2017 CVR Chassis Eagle Racing engine-powered machine. Looking for win number 18 on the season here at Crossville Speedway. Looking good as of now as we've got 21 laps of racing left as he's got a straightaway on the number 2 man, the 72 of Steve Russell. Zach Shannon in the number three spot. This is the first time we've seen the Z1 of Zach Shannon in the crate late model racing. You see him in the Sportsman, but we've got one looped around down in turn number four. That's going to be the 50 of Floyd Turner. Floyd Turner bringing out your caution flag in turn number four. We're fixing to go back to the green flag here in the crate late models with 20 laps remain of racing. Jesse Lowe gets on the loud pedal. Here we go, race fans. They're going to head down the back straightaway here at the Crossville Speedway. Thanks for watching on Speedway Video Productions. Jesse Lowe starting to pull away from the pack already. Zach Shannon was looking to the inside of Steve Russell, but could not make anything happen. Deke Waters going to look to the inside of Scott Cook down in turn number four. So your top five cars start to fan out as Jesse Lowe is going to take lap number eight. Steve Russell, Zach Shannon, Cook, and then Deke Waters has got company now. Justin Smith in the seven is trying to get around him, but he's going to overdrive it in turn number two. They're going to go down in turn number three, door to door. Once again, as Deke Waters is going to use the higher line. He's going to take that number five spot back. Deke Waters takes the number five spot back away from the seven. As Jesse Lowe is going to take lap number 10 with 15 more laps around Crossville Speedway. Michael Smith gets around the 27 of Jaden Frame. Perry Delaney in the 77 pulls down to the infield. His ninth's going to come to an end. Tough luck to Perry Delaney. So Jesse Lowe starting to pull far away from the pack. Steve Russell in second. Zach Shannon third. Scott Cook fourth. Deke Waters fifth. Scott Davenport sixth. Michael Smith, seventh. Then you're going to have the seven of Justin Smith as Jaden Frame's going to be working on Justin Smith out of turn four. So we've got just a few laps remaining here at Crossville Speedway. 11 more to go. Working on 10 to go this time around. Jesse Lowe starting to get into lap traffic. The first one he's going to run into is going to be Evan Taylor. He's going to look to the bottom side of the race, trying to get around the 36. Cannot get it done, so he's going to remain in behind that lap car. He's going to shoot back down to the bottom in turn number three. He's going to get it around him coming out of turn number four, so Jesse Lowe's put Evan Taylor a lap down. So they've fanned down around Crossville Speedway one by one. The next car is going to be the 50 of Floyd Turner that Jesse Lowe's got to get around. Is it going to give time to the 72 of Steve Russell to catch up to that beautiful-looking 5J of Jesse Lowe? So 18 laps are complete. 25 laps will be the distance. They've all fanned out as of right now as Jesse Lowe dominates the field. But he's in lap traffic. He's on the rear bumper of the 25 of Chase Walls. Steve Russell trying to catch some momentum to catch up to the 5J. But Jesse Lowe's got three cars in front of him. He's having to get on the binders before he wants to. He's going to go around Chase Walls, the 7 of Justin Smith. Now he's got to work on Jaden Frame. Four laps left for the crate late model feature. Once again, you're watching this on Speedway Video Productions. As Jesse Lowe's going to get around Jaden Frame with three laps to go. Zach Shannon running third, Steve Russell second. Still out front the 5J. Two more to go. Bullhorns are out at Crossville Speedway. Four to nine. Crate late model feature race as we come out of turn number four. 17 wins so far. He's going to take the white flag. Steve Russell in second. But coming into turn number three, the 2017 CVR chassis, Eagle Racing engine-powered machine, Gondola Steakhouse, Hampton Backhoe, Martell Sign Company, Crossville AutoZone 5J of Jesse Lowe picks up win number 18 on the season. Up next will be our Super Street Stock Feature Race. Super Street Stock Feature Race will be up next. Don't go anywhere.